After all the build-up, here we go. Super Bowl 50 is finally here.
Gentlemen, and welcome to Super Bowl 50. Congratulations on a great season, and good luck this evening.
Hey, much respect, homie.
I respect you too, boy. Real talk, we're going to grind this one out.
No question we're going to grind this out, baby.
Let's go! And here comes Pittsburgh, hoping to get off to the fast start. Well, the good thoughts and the shaking hands, that's all over with now. We've got a battle on the outside. Right now, Peterson has the upper hand.
He's holding me, man, I'm telling you. Come on, he can't cover me. He's holding me all day, bro.
He's trying to play the game.
That's just garbage.
Phil, it's clear Patrick Peterson has frustrated Antonio Brown to this point.
Come on, AB, I need you now. Stay with me. I can't have you doing this. Let's go.
The tension on the sideline, it keeps you on edge. Now take that and go out of the field and make it work for you.
AB, big bro, we got you. Stay focused.
Let's see if the Steelers can finally get in sync. This drive now will begin near the 50, late second quarter and down six.
Stay with me.
We need that fire. Let's get it.
No more messing around. It's time to ride.
Steelers have been shut down this first half, and let's see if this drive before the half can change their fortunes. Roethlisberger launches it down the field. Martavis Bryant, the second-year standout receiver, has the first touchdown of Super Bowl 50.
Right
now,
baby. There you go, Tay. Good job.
Come on, Ty. It's on us now. You do your part, I do my part, we win the ball game.
What a finish to the first half. The Steelers only 30 minutes away from their seventh Super Bowl title, leading it 7-6. Antonio Brown and Patrick Peterson, I love this battle. I can't get enough of it. But can Carson Palmer get things moving with this Cardinal offense?
Are we awake yet? Are we awake? Let's go now.
This time it's Floyd with the grab, and the Cardinals are moving again.
Oh, defense, this is ridiculous.
The field goal makes it 13 unanswered, and all the Steelers can do is watch.
Right here, win this situation right here, it's put up for shut up time.
Come on, D, we need it.
The Cardinals are backed up to their own end zone, but have a two-score lead late in Super Bowl 50. Unable to bring it in. Jim, I guess they were just trying to catch the defense off guard, but they did not. And as a quarterback, be very careful in a situation like this. After stopping the clock with an incomplete pass, Arizona now faces second and long.
Let's go, let's go.
Palmer looking to pass again. It's picked off. Cortez Allen has it. Cortez Allen keeps his game alive. Now can they get the onside kick?
Let's go, baby. We need to get bouncing and swinging. We bouncing and swinging all day. We need that fire back, baby.
Let's go! Pay the bills!
Pay
the bills! Come on, baby, one play!
Sweesome will try to execute it. And the onside kick. The ball is out, and it's recovered by the Steelers.
That's what I'm talking about, baby! Let's finish this game!
Make a play, Pete. I'm about to end it.
And now the game rests on the massive shoulders of Ben Roethlisberger. And this script is looking so eerily similar to what happened in Super Bowl 43.
All right, boys, here it is. Time to be the team we're supposed to be right now. Believe in the man to your left and to your right. It's our time right now. Let's go do it.
And now with the onside kick recovery, the Steelers are in position to win Super Bowl 50. If they can find the end zone, Brown with the reception, and that will move the chains. He beat Patrick Peterson on that play. believe how steady and reliable this guy is.
What's the phrase for it? He is money, Jim Nance. Man, he pays off every single time. You throw the football near him, he'll make the catch.
Finds Brown. Buchanan's there to make the tackle. Second down coming up. Time, obviously, a factor the rest of the way. Second down, four to go. Brown cannot be stopped right now. Another Steelers first down. The Steelers get set to snap the football. Only one timeout remaining here in the fourth. Ben Roethlisberger dropping back in shotgun formation. Roethlisberger sends it to Brown. And now the Steelers call their final timeout, trying to figure out how to get the football across to win Super Bowl 50.
Okay, big boy, what are you thinking here?
I like what we got. We got playmakers on the outside that can make plays. We got guys inside. It's your call. I just want to win this game.
All right, rally the troops here, big man. Tell them exactly what you need from them.
All right, boys, here it is. You got to leave it all on the line right here. Forget what the coaches said. Forget about everything that's going on outside of this huddle and this play right now. It's all about us, man on man, us versus them. I need everything you got right here. Leave it all on the line. We're world champions. Greatest feeling of your life, I promise you that. Let's go get it right here. Listen to me now. Eyes here. We got gun, wide trips weak. Steeler, wide trail, on the double. Ready? AB, listen to me. I'm coming to you on this play no matter what. It's do or die. It's all or nothing right now. Make the play for me, brother.
Pittsburgh is knocking on the door.
And no doubt a situation like this, you're looking for the fade route to Antonio Brown.
The pass doesn't find a mark. Roethlisberger looking for Antonio Brown on the play.
Well, look, you know, when you're down inside the 10-yard line, you're calling plays to try to score. Most of those plays are going to revolve around Antonio Brown.
Every play is huge now. Second down on the way. Second and goal from the board. Incomplete. Roethlisberger looking for Brown here near the end zone.
Yeah, don't hide your intentions. Hey, look, go up there and just say, we're going to throw it to our best guy. That's Antonio Brown. And I think if you keep throwing it his way, he'll make a play.
Third and goal from the four. And the throw is incomplete. Roethlisberger looking for Antonio Brown on the play.
Well, look, you know, when you're down inside the 10-yard line, you're calling plays to try to score. Most of those plays are going to revolve around Antonio Brown.
And Arizona comes up with the stop, and the Steelers are denied. Cardinals take Super Bowl 50.
Just prove it. No fly zone, baby.
The Steelers are out of time, and the Cardinals are the Super Bowl champions.
Welcome to Madden NFL 16. I'm Ben Roethlisberger. Let's pick a few options and get you back on the gridiron. First up, select your favorite team. Next, select your difficulty. We recommend starting on rookie or pro if you're new to Madden. Madden NFL 16 introduces new gameplay controls that allow you to become the ultimate playmaker on the field. Quarterbacks like myself now have the ability to deliver passes exactly where they need to be placed, whether that be touch passes between linebackers and safeties, back shoulder fades in the end zone, or high trajectory passes that allow receivers to go up and high point the football. Receivers and defensive backs will also be battling it out like never before with brand new two-man interactions and controls that will make each pass attempt fresh and exciting.
Yeah, I'm on a crossroads, lost hope and I lost quotes. My heart smokes for the fire that y'all to provoke. For the disbelievers, guess the game was missing the leader. Now they kissing my sneakers, lipstick on my Adidas. Word to the brethren, I'm running this like Russell Simmons. The game is a scrimmage, I'm stretching my muscle. It's blasphemous, blasphemous. Hazardous, hazardous, smash on they with this classic fash. Gave him the biz, you ain't even gotta ask if you do it to the casket dip. Believe it or not, legacy mean a lot. Fiending the reef for the top, yard dreaming I drop. Damn, high break, free from the break. Make prisoners up a Rikers Island, think out the box. This couldn't have been predicted by the Myers. Wrestling with religion and science.
Look, give me something.
258. Here we go. Blue 58. Hey. All right now. Blue 58.
There are even more categories and drills inside of Skills Trainer to help you keep your Madden game on point. Check them out. You're all set. It's time to go enjoy Madden NFL 16.
Everyone, I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Both defenses will have to be on the watch for a pair of tight ends looking to find seams in the secondary. It's Miller's Steelers going up against Nicholas's Cardinals. So let's go now to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, where Jim and Phil are on the call.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we should have an exciting matchup on our hands as we join you from Heinz Field.
Hello, friends. Jim Nance along with Phil Sims. And Phil, it's an absolutely gorgeous day here for football, and how will that factor into this game?
It's always a factor, Jim, when you have good weather. Now you can call anything you want and not worry about the elements disturbing your game plan. It's a complicated game. There's no doubt about it. But it's less complicated when you have good weather.
The Cardinals are back deep, ready to return the kickoff. And Sean Sweezum looks set now to kick it away. Nelson's got it. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line.
The Cardinals offense is led by quarterback Carson Palmer, who was having his career year in 2014 when suddenly was curtailed by knee injury.
Carson Palmer's tall, very accurate when he throws the football. That always is a good formula in the NFL.
First down at the 22. Incompletion on that hurried throw.
He is one of the most versatile players in the league, Andre Ellington.
Well, you're right. He is versatile, but I'll also say this. He's really fast, and that's a good attribute to have when you're talking about running backs in the NFL.
Here you go.
Second down and 10. Looking across the middle. They are all over him. Behind the line of scrimmage and a loss of one.
Well, we see it more and more. Football thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They do it that time. Nice catch, but a loss of yards on the play.
The Cardinals and the Steelers. Phil, these two met in a thrilling Super Bowl game back in 2008. Super Bowl 43 that came down to a last-minute touchdown.
It did. What an exciting game. Some of the big plays. But what I remember about that is the last drive by the Steelers and Ben Roethlisberger making an unbelievable, outstanding throw to win it for the Pittsburgh Steelers.
So now we'll bring out Zastadil to punt. Brown's got it now. Johnson's gonna make the tackle. That return's good for about 9. The offense is led by the quarterback who has virtually every Steelers franchise record for passing, Ben Roethlisberger.
Big Ben, I'm not sure. He might like a little punishment. Be careful when you hit him. He seems to play better.
First down at the 26. Here's Miller. Miller's taken down at the 46.
That time it was an easy completion for the quarterback on the play action pass, and it fools the defense because look how aggressive the offensive line is. They sold the play to the defense, and the quarterback took advantage.
Set up now at the 46.
The Steelers line up, split backfield.
Trying to beat the play clock.
They go screen with Bell. He's got a wide open alley.
What a nice job on the catch this time and breaking the tackle and getting those extra yards. When you make plays like that, if I was a quarterback, I'd give you a few more chances with the football.
Roethlisberger comes out in the pistol. First down at the 27. Weatherspoon's the one who made the big stop.
Got to give the defense some credit. On first down, there's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Coming to the line at the 30.
Second down and 13. Roethlisberger over to Antonio Brown. is how you draw it up, isn't it, Phil?
Oh, man, a quarterback loves guys that can make catches like this, and they're just so strong. They know how to zero in. They never lose concentration, and you've never seen drop a pass.
Breaking huddle at the 13. First and 10. He has the grab. That's a gain of 8.
Good play call that time by the offensive coordinator. Down inside, when you're inside that 20-yard line or the red zone, find ways to complete the pass. They did that time.
Defense ready in the goal line formation on this one. They need to get the playoff. The quarterback with the give to the fullback. And pick up about 4. They're just grinding away down here, inching closer to the end zone.
Well, that's what you got to do sometimes. It's hard always to think that you're going to come out and just make big plays. You got to do the dirty work, and this offense is doing it right now.
First and goal. Rothless breaks the plane. Touchdown. Bill, that's a terrific touchdown here late in the first, and they've now taken the lead.
Shoot, touchdowns are terrific no matter what time you get them, though, Jim. But, hey, late in the first, what a way to answer for that offense. That was a really, really sharp drive.
The extra point is good. The Steelers kicking team comes out now as the offense takes a break, and they deserve one after going down the field, mainly through the air with over 70 yards passing. Nelson's gonna test the coverage here. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Cardinals weren't able to get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt as they take the field here. Do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of information out there in that short drive, Jim, and you do that by showing different formations and plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive plays.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three and out business.
Well, it's a bad business to be in. I know. I get in a lot of bad businesses.
You might remember the time we were talking to James Harrison in a production meeting, and I was telling him I was squatting 165.
Yes, that's what he does his curls with, he noted right away, Jim. But he was impressed with the fact that at least you were doing squats. Sometimes on third and long from the defensive side, I like the fact that you can blitz. Send more guys than they can block. Make the quarterback throw the football quickly and short. Then it's all up to coming up and making the tackle.
Third and 10. Stands in the pocket. And Fitzgerald's going to pull in the bullet pass.
You just can't expect your defensive backs to cover that long. It's good coverage initially, but the quarterback had all day long, and sooner or later, these great receivers are going to get open.
Palmer's got it in the gun. Incomplete, almost going in the other direction.
Well, when there's man-to-man coverage on the defensive side, and the defense does a job like this where they are covering those receivers, there is nothing a quarterback can do except that, throw another incomplete pass.
Right now, 258. 258.
Second and 10. The Cardinals now move the chains. That's reception number 2 for him.
When you talk about throwing the football into open space, that's almost always against zone defenses. That's what we saw that time. Good job by the quarterback throwing it in there.
The Cardinals' offense is still out there as we get the second quarter underway. Double tight end formation. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Got a flag down here.
Holding offense.
The defense accepts the penalty.
Still first down.
First down at the 42. Ellington's handed the football. Mitchell's there to take him down.
When you see long runs like that by a running back, a lot of things have to happen. Of course, he has good vision and he has talent. But how about those blocks down the field, those blocks in the secondary? That's what creates long runs.
First down here. Let's see how they back up the big play here. Taylor's taking the handoff. They tackle him for a loss.
The defense was expecting run. They were up there. They were aggressive, crowd the line of scrimmage, and you just played right into their hands, and they got the tackle for the loss.
Coming to the line at the 25.
Right now, 118.
The Cardinals will take the snap from the 25.
I think it's important for the defense. Anytime it's a third and long situation for the offense to know where those first down markers are, give a little ground, and make sure you're able to come up and make the tackle short of the first down marker.
Just 25 yards to pay dirt. The Steelers go with the dime formation here on defense. Palmer standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. The defense gets the sack.
Well, if I was that quarterback, I'd be mad after getting sacked like that by the defensive end. Your offensive tackle just got to do a better job.
He'll try this one from 51. The field goal attempt is good. It's good.
We see it more and more. Long field goals by these kickers in this league now. They are strong, and they can kick it from a long way out.
And he'll start his return. And the tackle's made. The offense will start their drive from about the 31. The Steelers' offense coming back onto the field after a touchdown drive the last time they had it, and they certainly attacked that secondary and got there via the pass.
Well, Jim, let me ask you this. How would you like to be the defensive coordinator right now? Because you're over there, you don't know what's going to happen. No matter what you call, you feel like, hey, the quarterback's hot. He's probably going to beat what we're trying to do.
Hey,
Second down and 10.
Bell's going to take the handoff now.
The offensive line is just so passive. What do you expect? You got to be aggressive. You got to fire out and give the running back a chance.
Back in Super Bowl 43, Phil, when the Steelers won in the closing seconds, how about that catch by Santonio Holmes?
Yeah, it was a tremendous catch in the right corner of the end zone, and what a throw by Ben Roethlisberger. That goes down as one of the top five catches in Super Bowl history.
He's hit as he throws it.
And the Steelers are ready to punt this one away. Peterson's going to look for space now. And he's tackled down at the 36-yard line. The Steelers' defense starts this series knowing the last time they were out here, they allowed a field goal.
Yeah, it was not a good drive for him, and I know the coaches were upset. I was watching him on the sideline yelling at a few guys, so I expect a better effort this time out.
First down at the 36. It's the old counter play.
When you talk about cattle runs, what we just saw that time, the defense thinks the play's going one way, then a pulling guard or tackle comes around and catches a defensive lineman off guard and makes a good block.
Get ready. Move 95. Move 95.
The Cardinals have it at the 44. Ellington looking out wide. Tackle down at the 47.
Andre Ellington has the speed to get it done at the running back position in the NFL. He showed that speed that time and picked up a good first down.
We've hit the two-minute warning here in the first half. All right, following the two-minute warning, we've got a defense trying to maintain the lead as we head towards halftime. Ellington lined up as the single back. Dropping back three. Thomas is there to take him down. Second down now.
If you think you can get a playoff quickly and not use a timeout, you go with the hurry-up offense. That time, a good job by the coach and the quarterback.
That was Mitchell on the coverage that time.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
The Cardinals take it from the 38. Ellington's got it. First down.
When you're a quarterback throwing against zone defenses, look for the open space. That's what he did that time. He found it, and the receiver ran in there and made the catch.
They come to the line at the 31-yard line. The Steelers come out in a dime package. First and 10. Reaches out and grabs it. Taylor's taken down at the 25.
Well, they complete the pass, Jim, but doesn't get the first down. Sooner or later, you got to throw one down the field.
That short pass play picked up 6. It's now second down and 4. The shotgun formation. Gonna be a penalty here.
Holding offense.
The defense will take the penalty.
Still second down.
The line of scrimmage, the 35. From the shotgun,
big was that interception right before the half, Phil?
Big time. That's all I can say. That's what it was. For the situation, for your football team, and by that player, what a play he made.
The Steelers got absolutely nothing out of their previous possession, and here they are back on the field. Another three and out, I would have to think, would be very demoralizing to this team right now, Phil.
Yeah, it's going to be demoralizing to the offense, but I'll tell you who's going to be more demoralized is the defense, because they need to sit on the sidelines and get a little rest. So I know there's a lot of pressure on this offense right now.
Roethlisberger from the gun. Should have had it.
All you have to do is watch the head of the receiver. When they drop footballs, usually it's because you can see their head move the other way before the football gets there. That's what happened this time, and it's a drop pass.
Second and 10. It's complete to Martavis Bryant. The Cardinals signal for a timeout. They have two remaining. The completion sets them up now for third and 7. The Steelers get set at the line, needing to get to the 22 for a first. From the gun. Makes the reception. The Steelers get a first down.
Well, even though it's late in the first half, I think this is a good job by the coach going to the hurry-up offense. Going to see if they can make a few plays and get down there and get some points.
The Steelers snap it up at the 26. Roethlisberger going down the field. Got the catch. One-handed. The Steelers are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here. Offense getting set now following the timeout. The 31. Here we go. After the long gain, let's see what they do here. Ben Roethlisberger takes a look now from under center. Looking long. An important play for the defense to come up with just before the half. They didn't want to fall any further behind before the break.
You said it right. That keeps everybody's energy level up when you don't give up points in that situation to fall farther behind. And hey, I know the coaches are happy about it. They got to go in now and make some adjustments at halftime.
The Cardinals will try to put a little drive together and not give the football away, Phil, as each team seems to like one on treat it like it's a hot potato.
Well, sometimes it is a hot potato. Did you know back in 1985, Jim, I set a record for fumbles in a football season? It wasn't easy to do, but I accomplished it. It was a lot of hard work, and I got it done.
Let's go, let's go. Woo, 95. Woo, 95.
Second and short. Looking to go down the field here. Incomplete. Neither offense able to pull away in a first half that saw two defenses matching each other step for step. Larry Ridley coming up next to break down this first half. Spins out of the tackle.
The Steelers take the field here in the second half, looking to extend their lead in this one, partner.
Yeah, you know what you do? It's halftime is over. You come out here, you're not sure what the new game plan is going to be, but feel your way into the game. Don't take a chance early and turn the football over.
The Steelers take it from the 23. Bell's met at the 23. Bell takes his spot in the backfield. Second down and 10. Bell's going to secure the handoff.
How about the defensive line? Getting that penetration, getting off the football at the snap, and getting it done, getting in the backfield and making that tackle.
Loss of two on that play. Bell in the backfield, single back set. Third down and 13. Throws the pass. The pass ball's incomplete, and they fail to pick up a first down on this series. They're in punting formation. And he punts it, and it's going to sail out of bounds. Trying to play kick away from that dangerous returner. Coming to the line at the 44. Ellington is in the backfield. The Cardinals have it at the 44. Failing to complete that one. So, second down here. Two tight ends on the field here. Handoff. Ellington is tackled down.
Good job by the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
Third down. Catch today so far.
You just can't sit back there and play conservative defense in the NFL. The quarterbacks and receivers are too good. You play safe and you give up the first down.
Palmer's completion percentage, 50% on the day. The Cardinals will take the snap from the 25. Larry Fitzgerald has the catch. That play is going to be challenged.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So he challenged the play, and the coach's challenge does not pay off.
Well, I agree with the head coach still. I would have made this challenge because it was so important to the outcome of the game, and it was a little bit of a gamble, but it was worth it.
First and goal from the one. Ellington, and he's in. Bill, how big was that touchdown here midway through the third quarter to take the lead?
Well, Jim, I think anytime you start getting into the third quarter of football games, anytime you take the lead, it's a big deal because now you're going to start affecting the play calls of the offense and the defense of the other team.
The Steelers looking for a big return and hoping to find a way to regain the lead. Scores 10-7. To the end zone. Now the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10. Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown.
When you get a kick return for a touchdown, a lot has to happen. One, it takes talent by the kick returner, but look at all the good blocks we saw down the field and the speed of the kick returner. Touchdown.
Now they come out for the point after. Of course, this year, the new rule, the PAT is snapped from the 15-yard line, making the point after 13 yards longer than the pass, a 33-yard point after attempt.
The Cardinals return team is in position. Perhaps they can run one out pretty deep and shift the momentum. The scores 14-10. Nelson's got a chance to return this one. Tackle right at the 30-yard line after that return. The Steelers defense comes back onto the field. Did not look so good that last series, giving up the touchdown.
Oh, you know the coaches are upset. My gosh, they ran some of the most elementary defenses that you can run, and they had mistakes by the defensive players. So they coached them up on the sidelines. We'll see if we see different results.
James Harrison takes down the quarterback.
Oh, man, defensive coordinators love this. When you can hit, or this time, they sack the quarterback without even blitzing.
Second down coming up. Completion to Fitzgerald. That's his fourth catch of the day.
Not much the offense can do in a situation like this. Third and long, what you probably will have to do is either surprise them with a run or throw it short and hope somebody can make a play and pick up a first down.
The Cardinals will take the snap from the 30. And it's just thrown away. The defense again making quick work of things and setting up their offense now to extend the lead before heading to the final quarter, Phil.
What you want to do on the defensive side is beat your man that's lining up across from you. And right now, they are beating their man. There's no question, and another good series for the defense.
Antonio Brown will return this punt. He's tackled right at the 31.
There is nothing like a good return when you talk about special teams. Good blocking, the speed of the returner gets down the field, and after that tackle, now they have good starting field position.
The Steelers weren't able to get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt. As they take the field here, do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of information out there in that short drive, Jim, and you do that by showing different formations and plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive plays.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three-and-out business.
Well, it's a bad business to be in. I know. I get in a lot of bad businesses. Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
First down and 10. Bell's handed the football. In the end, it picks up only a yard. Second down. Bell takes his spot in the backfield. Second and 10. They hand it off to him again.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
We head to the fourth quarter, and these defenses have certainly shined, but they both know one little lapse and it could cost your team the game.
Yeah, it could. If you have a big time mental breakdown, it would cost you the game. But I look at this too, Jim. Low scoring, here we go in the fourth quarter. I'm looking at whichever defense makes that big play to win the game. That's what I'm looking forward to. Who could get that big turnover?
Chip shot here. And converts on the three.
Well, that time the offense had great field position. They don't take advantage of it, but at least they get 3 points. Good job by the kicker coming in and getting some points on the board.
Nelson's got it. And the tackle's made. The offense will start their drive from about the 31. The Steelers have been all about defense here of late. Three and out the last time they were on the field.
Yeah, it was a really good drive by them, just stopping the offense so quick. And it looked, every aspect worked well. The coaches had to be really happy with the defense.
Out of the gun. John Brown brings it down. That's his first reception today.
Well, the quarterback showed off his arm strength that time, didn't he? He put the football right on the money, on a line, right into the receiver's hands.
Following that completion, second and short.
Get ready.
The give. Shazier's in on the tackle. Ellington is in the backfield. Now first and 10. Carson Palmer throws the long pass. Touchdown, Cardinals. They got the points they were looking for, and they got them right away here in the fourth. We're all tied up.
Yeah, you know, when it gets into fourth quarter of football games, players do start to look at that clock. They look at the score, and they think about winning and losing. And when you do that, that usually picks up the pace of play.
Ball's on the tee. Got a tie game now. The score's 17-17. He'll take it from the one. And he's tackled right at the 30-yard line after that return. The Steelers put some points on the board on their previous possession, but it was just a field goal. They'll be looking to add some more right here.
Yeah, they will. And, you know, listen, you know, when you talk about touchdown drives, you have to kick a field goal. What does that mean? That means you failed on third down. Just not a good play on third down. They got to do better in that situation. If they do, that's going to lead to 7 points.
The Steelers will take the snap from the 30. They go screen with Bell. Peterson that time. The tackle.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion.
The Steelers will take the snap from the 40. Wants to go deep, and it falls incomplete. He had an open receiver that time and just misfired on the deep throw.
Yeah, I think he got too excited. The fact that he saw a receiver down the field wide open, he got excited. That's why he overthrew it just a little bit.
Second down and 10. Reaches out and snatches it. Johnson's met after a gain of 8.
Good job by the quarterback that time. Makes the decision. Throws it short. It does not get the first down. But I promise you, third and short is a lot easier than having third and long.
On the way, third down. Bell takes his spot in the backfield. Bell's taking the handoff.
Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Even though the defense knows you're probably going to run the football, it's third and short. If you run hard, all you need is a little bit of a lane. We see it there, able to get the first down.
First down at the 47. To the outside, Bell. Inside the 50.
The game is tied and time is a factor.
Williams is in the backfield. 2 minutes to go before this one's in the books. Just 2 minutes left in this one. We're back now for the end of the fourth quarter. The Cardinals will come out in the dime. Roethlisberger's going to take the snap from the shotgun. And intercepted.
Holding offense.
The defense accepts the penalty.
First down.
At the line of scrimmage, the 41. The Steelers come out with a split backfield. Roethlisberger takes the snap from the gun. Gets his feet down right near the chalk.
Well, what you do, Jim, in a situation like this, you take the short game where you get the completion and get out of bounds, and you hope the defense gets drawn up. So maybe in the next play or two, you can throw it down the field and get big yards.
The Cardinals with two extra defensive backs in the dime.
Second down and seven.
Going deep. And that's Matthew, who almost made the interception. They went for the deep throw, but the defensive back was there.
Yeah, good job that time. I got to give the defensive back a lot of credit. He was not caught sleeping out there. He was alert, read the right keys, and he was right with the receiver to knock down that deep throw.
Seven. The Steelers now move the chains.
Well, when you talk about throwing these sideline routes or the out route, it is about timing. When that receiver makes that break to go towards the sideline, that football has to be in the air. Nice throw and catch that time.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. The Steelers from the 22. They'll go ground. Away from the ball, there's a flag down on the field.
Holding offense.
The defense will take the penalty.
Bell takes his spot in the backfield. The Steelers lined up, bunch formation. The Steelers have it at the 29. Bell will get it on the toss.
brought down at the 26. The Cardinals defense will stop the clock here with under two to go as they want to preserve the clock. And now they'll try over again on second down.
We are tied, and this game has less than a minute to go.
Bell's going to take the handoff now.
There's a flag right there.
Holding offense.
The defense accepts the penalty.
Still second down.
The Steelers come to the line, fourth quarter, with two timeouts remaining. The Steelers take it from the 28. Scanning the field, has the grab. Johnson's brought down after picking up six on this play. Third down now. The Steelers will set up. The 12 is the first down line. Bell's going to secure the handoff. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. The Cardinals will, of course, call the timeout now to stop the clock. The field goal unit now has a chance to give them the lead here late in the fourth.
The kick is good.
They were thinking touchdown that entire drive, but in the end, they have to go field goal. They convert here in the closing stages.
Well, I'm sure they would have loved to kick that field goal as time expired, but that's not the case. Good job of moving the football down the field, getting that field goal to put them ahead, and now the defense, go out there and do your job.
That return's good for about 26. Lawrence Timmons coming onto the field now, and it looks like this defense could more or less wrap up the game if they can get another big stop right here, partner.
Jim, they can. There's no doubt about it. Now you have the wherewithal. In other words, you can't worry about, oh, if we do something wrong, we're going to lose. No, don't think that way. Be positive and make that play.
Holding offense.
The defense will take the penalty.
Still first down.
Now on first down. Every snap crucial the rest of the way.
Get ready.
Homer's back in shotgun formation. That pass well defended. Second down. Late in the fourth quarter. The Steelers lined up in the nickel.
Let's go, let's go.
Palmer's gonna take it from the gun. And intercepted. What a horrible time to throw the interception. But hats off to the defense here, Phil. They come up with the stop, the play, the takeaway. Just the right time.
Yeah, listen, I give the defense all the credit in a situation like this. You know, they took advantage of a quarterback who they knew was going to have to take a chance, and they were ready to pounce on it.
It was a close one, and at the final whistle, what a win for that one team.
It sure is. What a thrill to win a close game in the NFL. Now, you think about it, how hard it is just to get one win and how tough it was out there. And hang on, man, it's a great feeling.
Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nantz saying so long.